Francis! Your Holiness, your distinguished dignitaries, the bishops, priests, the religious and the lay faithful, all of you here present, benvenuti tutti, you are all most welcome. Allow me to invite Bishop John Baptist Kawa of Masaka Diocese to come and address us, and also welcome His Holiness to the Cathedral, Bishop John Baptist Kawa.
Your Holiness, Pope Francis, Uganda, the land of the martyrs, welcomes you, the sad success of Peter and the Vicar of Christ to this country. Where you are now was the palace of King Mutesa I, who welcomed the first Catholic missionaries to his kingdom and gave them permission to evangelize his people. When he changed the sites, he donated this very hill to the Catholic missionaries, who also established themselves here. In audience, Your Holiness, are the members of the Uganda Episcopal Conference, the Chairman Secretary General of the Association of Members of Episcopal Conferences of Eastern Africa, AMESEA, the representatives of SECA, and our brothers from other Episcopal Conferences. Priests and religious, congregations of men and women of Uganda, and the major seminarians from our five national and inter-diocesan seminaries studying philosophy and theology are among those you're going to address. This nation is blessed with a good number of vocations, both to the priesthood and to the religious life. Some of our priests have volunteered to serve as fidei donum internally in Uganda and abroad. The religious and priests, men and women, are quite committed to the work of evangelization in all its facets. Both priests and religious highly appreciated your challenging apostolic exhortation, Evangelii Gaudium, which they are studying attentively. They are also living the insights you suggested them for the year of the religious. They feel blessed and privileged to host you as they come to the close of this year. The recent encyclical Laudato Si is yet another clear and audible message which not only awakens our awareness to our common origin, but also challenges us to develop a loving care for Mother Earth. Your Holiness, we also thank you for having convoked the Synod on the Family. As priests and religious, we are committed to defend and restore the dignity of the family institution. Your Holiness, equally we thank you for the recent declaration of the Year of God's Mercy. And we pledge ourselves to help our people discover and rediscover the mercy of God. As religious and priests in this country, we are faced with many challenges. We pray that you pray for us to persevere, to love our vocation, and to be fruitful in this ministry. So, Your Holiness, religious and priests are happy to host you tonight. Your Holiness, we have a priest and a religious to share with us their testimonies. I call upon the priest, and then after the religious.
Your Holiness, Pope Francis I, I'm most humbled at the same time honored to say a word of welcome and greeting on behalf of the Ugandan National Diocesan Priest Association and on my own behalf on the occasion of your first pastoral and spiritual pilgrimage to Uganda, the land of the martyrs and the Great Lakes, the source of the River Nile. We thank God for the gift of your pilgrimage to the holy sites of Munyonyo and Namugongo, the sites of the martyrdom of St. Charles Luanga and companions. Like your predecessors, Pope Blessed Paul VI, and Pope St. John Paul II, who visited us in 1969 AD and 1993 AD respectively. Your pilgrimage adds value and confirms our faith and blesses us with joy to live the gospel truth through family life, consecrated life, and the priesthood. It is also our honor and privilege to present to you all our 1,562 diocesan priests and missionaries alive for your blessing and prayer. From 1913 AD, when the church in Uganda was blessed by God with the first two diocesan priests south of the Sahara, Father Victor Mukasa and Father Basilio Lumu, vocations to Christian life, consecrated life, and priesthood continue to rise. Finally, we give thanks and glory to God for the Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Michael Augustine Bloom, the Uganda Episcopal Conference Chairman, His Grace John Baptist Odama, and the Government of the Republic of Uganda, through His Excellency the President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, for having invited you to Uganda. May Almighty God, through the worthy intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Queen of the Apostles, and the Holy Martyrs of Uganda, bless you always. I am Father Matthew Okun Lagoro, Chairman of the Ugandan Diocesan Priests.
Your Holiness, the Association of the Religious in Uganda welcome you, Your Holiness, to their beloved country, well known as the Pearl of Africa and the Land of the Martyrs. The association consists of 91 institutes with a current total of 7,000 members. The mission of the association is to collaborate, support, and empower each institute to live its unique charism within the mission of the Holy Catholic Church today. And the vision is to be a prophetic body of religious men and women inspired by gospel values for our own transformation and the society. We do this through prayer, catechesis, health care, education, pastoral and social services. Your Holiness, we are blessed that this visit has happened during the year of consecrated life and on the eve of the Jubilee Year of Mercy. The encyclical Rejoice opened with a phrase, "Wherever consecrated people are, there is always joy." Joy. We commit ourselves to witnessing this joy of the gospel in simplicity and care of the poor and vulnerable. Holy Father, in conclusion, we request for your continued parental blessings on us. On our part, we shall always pray for your holiness. I am Sister Susan Claire Ndezo on behalf of the Association of Religious in Uganda.
Your Lordship, Bishop Kagwa, may you accomplish the second task kindly.
Your Holiness. Your Holiness, I know you are eager to talk to us, religious and priests. I invite you to address the assembly.
Io lascerò al vescovo incaricato della vita consacrata il messaggio che ho scritto per voi perché sia pubblicato in tutti voi.
I will hand over to His Grace the Bishop a message that was prepared and that you will also be able to look at afterwards.
I excuse me for speaking in my mother language, but I don't know speaking English. Tres cosas le quiero decir.
I'd like to say three things to you this evening.
Primero de todo, en el libro del Deuteronomio, Moisés recuerda a su pueblo, no olviden.
In the book of Deuteronomy, Moses says, do not forget.
Y lo repite durante el libro varias veces. No olvidar.
And he says it various times. Do not forget.
No olvidar todo lo que Dios hizo por el pueblo.
Don't forget everything that God did for his people.
Lo primero que lo quiere decir a ustedes es que tengan, pidan la gracia de la memoria.
The first thing I want to say to this evening is ask for the grace never to forget, but to keep alive the memory.
Como le dije a los jóvenes, por la sangre de los católicos ugandeses.
As I said to the young people today, through the veins of young people today and all Ugandan people,
está mezclada la sangre de los mártires.
Is flowing blood of the martyrs.
No pierdan la memoria de esta semilla.
Don't please lose the memory of this great seed.
Para que así sigan creciendo.
So that you can nourish it and that you can grow.
El principal enemigo de la memoria es el olvido.
The great enemy of memory is forgetfulness, forgetting.
Pero no es el más peligroso.
But it's not the most dangerous.
El enemigo más peligroso de la memoria es acostumbrarse a heredar los bienes de los mayores.
The most dangerous thing against memory is getting too comfortable.
La iglesia en Uganda no puede acostumbrarse nunca al recuerdo lejano de sus mártires.
You can't become too comfortable laying on these memories of the past, just remembering them.
Mártir significa testigo.
Martyrdom means witness.
La iglesia en Uganda, para ser fiel a esa memoria, tiene que seguir siendo testigo.
To be faithful generally to that witness, it must itself always be a witness and alive.
No tienen que vivir de renta.
It mustn't live just on superficial things, on memories.
Las glorias pasadas fueron el principio, pero ustedes tienen que hacer las glorias futuras.
Glories that did exist in the past, and they're real and true, but you are part of the future glory.
Y ese es el encargo que le da la iglesia a ustedes. Sean testigos.
And that is the mandate that the church gives you, to be
witnesses. Como fueron
witnesses.
Testigos los mártires que dieron la vida por el evangelio.
To be witnesses just as the martyrs laid down their lives for the gospel.
Para ser testigos, segunda palabra que les quiero decir.
To be witnesses, the second word I wish to say,
es necesaria la fidelidad.
Is fidelity.
Fidelidad a la memoria.
Fidelity to memory.
Fidelidad a la propia vocación.
Fidelity to your own charism, vocation.
Fidelidad al celo apostólico.
Fidelity to apostolic zeal.
Fidelidad significa seguir el camino de la santidad.
Fidelity means following the way of holiness.
Fidelidad significa hacer lo que hicieron los testigos anteriores, ser misionero.
Fidelity means what they did in the past, being good missionaries.
Quizás acá en Uganda hay diócesis que tienen muchos sacerdotes y diócesis que tienen pocos.
There are dioceses I know that have many numbers of clergy and others that have very little.
Fidelidad significa ofrecerse al obispo para ir a otra diócesis que necesita misioneros.
Fidelity means having a diocesan bishop that's generous in offering priests to a neighboring or a different diocese that needs clergy.
Y esto no es fácil. Fidelidad significa perseverancia en la vocación.
Fidelity means persevering in one's vocation.
Y acá quiero agradecer de una manera especial.
And I want to thank here especially
el ejemplo de fidelidad que me dieron las hermanas de la Casa de la Misericordia.
The example of fidelity that I received in the House of Mercy.
Fidelidad a los pobres, a
fidelity
los enfermos,
to the poor,
a los más necesitados,
to the infirm, disabled,
porque Cristo está allí.
Because Christ is there.
Uganda fue regada con sangre de mártires, de testigos.
The blood of martyrs has flown on the ground of this
hoy
great country.
Es necesario seguir regándola, y para eso nuevos desafíos, nuevos testimonios, nuevas misiones.
The earth of Uganda needs to always have the blood on this earth, on this ground, so that there can be new witnesses and new messengers of Christ.
Si no, van a perder la gran riqueza que tienen.
If not, you can lose, end up losing this great treasure that you have.
Y la perla de África.
And the pearl of Africa
terminará guardada en un museo.
Would be left consigned to a museum.
Porque el demonio ataca así, de a poquito.
Because the devil attacks in that way, little bit by little bit.
Y estoy hablando no solo para los sacerdotes, también para los religiosos.
And I'm not just
speaking los sacerdotes,
to
lo quise decir de una manera especial respecto al problema de la misionariedad.
I'm not just speaking to the clergy here, I'm speaking to all religious, but I really wanted to direct that idea of missionary spirit especially to priests.
Que las diócesis con mucho clero se ofrezcan a las de menos clero.
When I say that the diocese offers priests,
entonces
to other
Uganda
places,
va a seguir siendo misionera.
So that Uganda can always be missionary.
Memoria,
memory,
que significa fidelidad.
Fidelity.
Y fidelidad que solamente es posible con la oración.
And fidelity which is only possible through prayer.
Si un religioso, una religiosa, un sacerdote deja de rezar o reza poco,
if a religious or a priest stops praying,
porque dice que tiene mucho trabajo,
because he has or she has too much work,
ya empezó a perder la memoria.
Then he or she has begun to lose their memory.
Y ya empezó a perder la fidelidad.
And to lose their fidelity.
Oración que significa también humillación.
Prayer also means humiliation.
La humillación de ir con regularidad al confesor.
Humiliation to constantly go to your confessor.
A decir los propios pecados.
To confess your own sins.
No se puede renguear de las dos piernas.
You can't walk on one leg and walk on the other. You have to walk on two.
Los religiosos, las religiosas y los sacerdotes no podemos llevar doble vida.
We can't have a double life.
Si sos pecador, si sos pecadora, pedí perdón.
If you are a sinner, ask for forgiveness.
Pero no mantengas escondido lo que Dios no quiere.
But don't keep hidden what God doesn't want to remain.
No mantengas escondida la falta de fidelidad.
Let there not be this fault against fidelity.
No encierres en el armario la memoria.
Don't close into your closet, into the cupboard, this important treasure of memory.
Memoria.
Memory.
Nuevos desafíos.
New challenges.
Fidelidad a la memoria.
Fidelity.
Y oración.
And prayer.
Que la oración siempre empieza con reconocerse pecador.
Prayer always begins with recognizing oneself to be a sinner.
Con esas tres columnas, la perla del África seguirá siendo perla y no solo una palabra de diccionario.
With these great three pillars, the pearl of Africa will not just remain the pearl of Africa, but the true missionary spirit of that pearl.
Que los mártires que dieron fuerza a esta iglesia los ayuden a seguir adelante en la memoria, en la fidelidad y en la oración. Y por favor, les pido que no se olviden de rezar por mí.
That the martyrs may constantly help you and aid you by their intercession, so that you may keep alive memory, fidelity, and prayer. And finally, I ask you all in a special way to pray for me.
Thank you very much. Ahora los invito.
I now invite you all
a rezar todos juntos un Ave María a la Virgen.
We stand and we pray together as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
May God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us sing Katonda Kuma Papa, His Holiness is processing out. Let us sing Katonda Kuma Papa.
Thank you. from your word.